Students, welcome back to chapter metallurgy. In the previous module, we were studying about the extraction of copper as well as iron. So now we are going to study about the extraction of gold and silver from its respective, that is, reagents, like we are using here, that is cyanide as well as zinc. And this is the process where there is the involvement of oxidation as well as reduction takes place. See, that is extraction of gold and silver. See, that is gold and silver, they are considered as noble metals. And this extraction of gold as well as silver takes place from its native ores. And during extraction, two important processes involved. One is oxidation, the second is reduction. And this method is also known as hydrometallurgy, since we are dealing with an aqueous solution. Okay, so that's why it is called as what, hydrometallurgy. So that is, during extraction of gold and silver, whatever the ore is, you know, so that ore is treated with sodium cyanide, which acts as a leaching agent. Okay, so this is sodium cyanide. So when we treat with a sodium cyanide, we are going to get the complexes. So that is, different ion complex are obtained. So the metal, which is like gold or silver, okay, so that metal will be completely dissolved in the cyanide, whereas the impurities remain insoluble. In the sense, it is the leaching process, right? So what is leaching? The process in which the metal is completely dissolved, whereas the impurities remain undissolved. So that is the leaching process. Similarly, in the extraction of gold or silver, whatever the gold or silver metal is there, so that metal is completely going to dissolve in the cyanide solution, whereas the impurities remain undissolved. In the second step, whatever the complex which is obtained in the first step, that is, once we treat with, that is, gold or silver with a sodium cyanide or potassium cyanide, we are going to get the respective complex. So that complex is further reduced in the presence of zinc. Here the zinc acts as a reducing agent. So we have a following reactions. Once you see the reactions, you will come to understand what exactly or how exactly the process runs. So these are the reactions which are taking place in the, that is, leaching process, that is, in the leaching of gold or silver. So here what happens exactly, this the process name is Mac-Arthur-Forrest cyanide process. Okay, Mac-Arthur-Forrest cyanide process. In this process, see what we have taken, that is gold, right? So this gold, when it is leached with the sodium cyanide, Cn minus, okay, we have written all the equations in where ionic form, okay, Cn minus. So now that is gold which is going to, that is, react with a Cn minus, that is, aqueous cyanide solution in the presence of O2, which acts as an oxidizing agent. So we are going to get, that is, dicyanoaurate, okay, dicyanoaurate complex is obtained. Later it is reduced in the presence of zinc to get, that is, gold, pure gold is obtained. And see here, this is one more example with, that is, a silver. Ag stands for silver. Similarly, here also we are using, that is, zinc, which acts as a reducing agent. And finally, we are going to get, that is what, silver. Silver metal is obtained. And the name of this process is Mac-Arthur-Forrest cyanide process. Thank you.